Yes, class. Good morning. Today we'll discuss here about quadratic equations. What is quadratic equations? How to find out the roots of the quadratic equations, and how to find out the roots of imaginary roots of the quadratic equations. Yes, now discuss about your quadratic equation. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. This is the standard equation of the quadratic equations. This is the standard equation of the quadratic equation, where a, b, c are real numbers, where a, comma b, comma c belongs to real number, but a does not zero. The value of the a will be not zero. Bc in zero, but a will be not zero. Other a, b, c or belongs are real numbers, except a is not zero. Second thing, how to find of the roots of this quadratic equations. So this is a simple idea to find the roots of the minus b plus minus root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. You know the name of this quantity here, b square minus 4ac, are called here discriminant. This is called the d, and b square minus 4ac. If d is less than 0, if d value of the d is value of, after solving this portion, if value of the d come here less than 0, means negative numbers, then you can say to this quadratic equation having the imaginary root. So then given quadratic equation have imaginary and different root. Imaginary, otherwise unequal root. Then you can say, suppose value of this d less than 0 means negative numbers, then you can say that the given quadratic equation have the imaginary and unequal roots. So what is the imaginary here? You know, then value of the imaginary here is not on it. Then you can say that this value of the value of this x, what is the value of the x? Minus b plus minus root 4ac minus b square, and this is the eta upon 2a. This you can say in this root of the in this form also, so minus ac minus b square are here eta here outside of the multiply, or value of the eta here minus root minus 1. Then you multiply here, then you will come here the same area. Then this form you can write in this form. Otherwise, this eta here, eta is called imaginary roots. Eta here called imaginary roots. Then this part is called the imaginary part. How to find the value of this quantity, how to find the roots of this quantity equation, according this way, otherwise you can this way, then find the value d, and then you can write the imaginary roots. Yes, note down it, then next portion. Yes, student, how to understand these questions, how to find the imaginary roots here. I am taking one first question number first from the exercise 5.3, question number first here, solution. X square plus 3 equal to 0, x square equal to minus 3. Then square transpose the right side here, then this will convert minus 3. Then this will convert here minus 3 and plus minus here. Then you can say plus minus root 3. root 3 you can write this way, and minus 1 is write in this way. This minus 3 you can write in two form, root 3 and minus 2, minus 1, root minus 1. The value of this minus 1 is called the eta, plus minus eta root 3. So this is your value of the x. This is your roots of the x. What value of the roots of the x? Here, plus minus eta root 3. Because minus root 1 is called the eta. Eta. So this minus 1 converted into eta, and root 3 are same that, and then you can write here in this form. So suppose you are squaring the both sides here, then this will get how. Now we check this. Suppose you plus minus eta root 3. Suppose you squaring both sides. Squaring both sides means x square plus minus eta root 3, and then this square. Then the left side will become here x square plus minus eta square, and this is root 3 is 3. Then this is called eta square equal to minus root 3, and eta equal to x plus 3 equal to 0. That means value of this quadratic equation means this answer is correct here. When you squaring both sides here, this solution, if you squaring both sides, you will get the questions here. Means your answer is correct. Squaring both sides here, x square and eta root 3 square, this square here, eta square here, right, root square here, 3. Value of the eta square, or value of the eta square is called is minus 1. But then eta square converted to minus 1 into 3. The minus 3 transposing left side, so the eta square plus 3 equal to 0. This means your answer is correct. Yes, note down it. This is a checking process. Then you note down it. Yes, students, how to solve this question here? Now look here. First, this is the given quadratic equations. You will find the roots of these equations. Yes, now look here. First, you write the question here 2x square plus x plus 1 equal to 0. This equation is the standard form of the quadratic equation. So now you can write here standard form equation a square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Equating both equation here, what value of the a here? Value of the a 2, b here 1, and c here 1. Means no any number here, means the coefficient is 1. Value of these, x coefficient here b, then here 1. C value is 1, s square coefficient here 8 means equal to 2. This is the coefficient of this. After that, you will check here ki this equation having the real root or imaginary root. First, you will check here with help of the discriminant b square minus 4ac. First, you will check this ki this equation, quadratic equation having real roots or imaginary roots. Then, putting the value here, 1 square minus 4a into c. 1 minus 4 to the 8, this is the minus 7. The value of the d, this is, I mean, this is less than 0. This is condition of the less than 0, negative value here. You can say the given equation has imaginary root. So, given equation has imaginary roots. Means given equation has imaginary roots, then you can solve with the help of imaginary roots. So the, now you have look here, x equal minus b plus minus root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. Using this identity here, a value of the, this value of this here, b square minus 4ac, b square minus 4ac already share value minus 7. You can write here minus b, so means minus 1 plus minus, this is, you can write here root minus 7 upon 2 into 1. A value of this here a equal to 2, so then you write here 2. Value of the b are 1 and बी स्क्वायर माइनस फोर ए सी ऑलरेडी यू हैव सॉल्व हियर, बी स्क्वायर माइनस फोर ए सी वैल्यू कम है माइनस सेवन, तो यू पुट इट डायरेक्ट माइनस सेवन रूट सेम हियर, एंड टू ए वैल्यू ऑफ द ए आर ऑल्सो टू, टू टू जब फोर, देन यू राइट योर माइनस वन प्लस माइनस, देन यू राइट रूट सेवन इंटू रूट माइनस वन, देन यू गेट टू टू जब फोर, माइनस वन प्लस माइनस आईटा रूट सेवन अपॉन फोर, देन दीज आर दी टू रूट्स, वैल्यू ऑफ द रूट माइनस वन इज इक्वल टू आईटा, एंड देन यू राइट हियर दिस इन दिस फॉर्म वैल्यू ऑफ द एक्स, देन यू कैन राइट हियर टू टू रूट्स ऑफ हियर एक्स इक्वल टू माइनस वन प्लस आईटा रूट सेवन अपॉन फोर, सेकेंड माइनस वन माइनस आईटा रूट सेवन अपॉन फोर, दीज आर टू रूट्स ऑफ द रूट्स ऑफ द एक्स प्लस माइनस, फर्स्ट इज पॉजिटिव फॉर्म, फर्स्ट आई एम राइटिंग द पॉजिटिव फॉर्म, सेकंड आई एम राइटिंग द नेगेटिव फॉर्म, हियर प्लस माइनस टू साइन, हियर फर्स्ट साइन आई एम टेकिंग पॉजिटिव, सेकंड साइन आई एम टेकिंग द नेगेटिव, सो दिस दे आर द टू रूट्स ऑफ द गिवन क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन, दिस इज योर आंसर, टू रूट्स ऑफ द गिवन क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन, यू विल राइट एवरी फर्स्ट यू विल चेक हियर डिस्क्रिमिनेंट हियर टू गिवन इक्वेशन हैविंग रियल रूट और इमेज रूट, फर्स्ट विल चेक वैल्यू हियर कम लेस देन जीरो मीन्स माइनस सेवन इज लेस देन जीरो, देन गिवन इक्वेशन हैज यू हैव इन हियर इमेज रूट, सो यू विल सॉल्व अकॉर्डिंगली विद हेल्प ऑफ द इमेज रूट फॉर्मुलाइज, देन पुटिंग द वैल्यू हियर, देन फाइंड दिस एंड फाइंड द टू रूट्स, यस नोट डाउन, देन नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, यस क्लास नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन आई एम टेकिंग क्वेश्चन नंबर 50 हियर, सेम क्वेश्चन हियर, दिस इज गिवन क्वाड्रेटिक क्वेश्चंस, फर्स्ट यू विल कंपेयर द स्टैंडर्ड इक्वेशन ऑफ द क्वाड्रेटिक, देन यू विल फाइंड द रूट्स ऑफ दिस इक्वेशंस, यस नाउ स्टार्ट द सॉल्यूशन हियर, यू स्टार्ट द सॉल्यूशन हियर, x स्क्वायर प्लस 3x प्लस 5 इक्वल टू 0, यू इक्वेटिंग x स्क्वायर प्लस dx plus c equal to 0, then marker. Equating here a equal here 1, b equal 3 and c equal 5. This is your first, write the standard form, this is standard form, equating is standard form the given equations, the coefficient a, x square here a, then here 1, here coefficient of x here b, then here 3, and coefficient of here c here is equal to 5. First, same that you will find that, you will check this given equation having real root or imaginary root, which equation here, then you will check first, d equal b square minus 4ac with help of this. So what value of the b here? 3. Square of 3, square minus 4. A is 1 or c is 5. So 3 is 9. 5 4 is 20. This is minus 11. Value of the b here minus 11. This is the less than 0. Subtract the 11, this is less than 0. It means given equation having real roots. So given equation have imaginary and unequal roots. Given equation have imaginary and equal roots. Yes. Then using the identity of the image minus b plus minus root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. Here b square minus 4ac here, this is the value of the given d, discriminant. And this is already solved here, value here minus 11. We are putting value here, what is value of the b? Minus 3 plus minus root minus 11 upon 2 into a. Value of a is 1. First you write the b minus 3, b square minus 4 is already solved here, when you come here minus 11 and putting minus 11, then you write here माइनस थ्री प्लस माइनस यू राइट देयर 11 इनटू रूट माइनस वन अपॉन टू देन यू कैन राइट देयर माइनस थ्री प्लस माइनस आईटा रूट 11 अपॉन टू दिस इज वैल्यू ऑफ दिस दिस इज रूट ऑफ द गिवन क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन दिस क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन दिस इज रूट ऑफ द गिवन क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन यू हैव टू रूट्स प्लस माइनस देन राइट इन सेपरेट फॉर्म एक्स इक्वल माइनस थ्री फर्स्ट यू राइट दी पॉजिटिव फॉर्म फर्स्ट यू राइट दी पॉजिटिव फॉर्म यर आईटा रूट 11 अपॉन टू सेकेंड माइनस थ्री माइनस आईटा रूट 11 अपॉन टू फर्स्ट रूट आई एम राइटिंग यर पॉजिटिव फॉर्म सेकेंड राइटिंग यर नेगेटिव फॉर्म बिकॉज यू आर टू रूट्स यू आर हैविंग टू रूट्स देन राइट इन सेपरेट फॉर्म पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव दिस इज योर आंसर Very simple things here. You have learned this LTR. First, you will check here in every question. A given equation have a real root or imaginary root. First, we check in this way. What value are less than zero, greater than zero, equal to zero? Three conditions here. But mostly, this exercise always question come in this condition, imaginary roots. Less than greater than zero or equal to zero. These are question in the class 10 question standard. But in this class 11, you are having only imaginary roots. Suppose you are having here equal to zero means equal roots, imaginary a real root and equal root. Suppose you are greater than zero, the real and different roots. And less than zero means imaginary and unequal roots. Yes, note down it. Yes, student. Next question. I am taking question number exercise. This is the exercise. Question number first. This is the important questions. This exercise is a mixed exercise. 5.1, 5.2, 5.3. In this exercise, I am taking question number first. You know that iota 18 plus 1 upon iota 25 whole power is 3. You know what value of the iota r? Value of the iota r minus root 1. Iota square equal to minus 1, iota cube equal minus iota, or iota 4 equal to plus 1. These values keep in mind in these values, according to these values, we will solve this question. Yes, now start the question here. Iota 18, solution start here. Iota 18 is divided 2 into 9 plus 1 upon iota 25 and whole power is 3. First of all, I convert in this iota 18 is 2 9 by 18. Means 18 break down 2 into 9. And this whole power 1 extra is 25 equal to 1. And iota is 25 and I am not writing here same that. 1 extra 25 means 1. After that you will do this. What value of the iota square? Iota square will be minus 1. This means minus 1 is whole power is 9 plus. This iota 25, I break down is the iota 25, here iota into iota 24 in this form. Iota 25 break down here iota into iota 24. Just you write here iota and iota 24 and whole power is 3. After that, minus 1 having the odd number of exponent, then this will got minus 1 plus 1 upon iota. Iota 24 means 4 sigma. This iota 24 I have break down it. Iota 4 into 6. This iota is same. This iota 24 break down 4 into 6. So then same that here. Minus 1 plus 1 upon iota, and what value of the iota 4? Value of the iota 4 is plus 1. This is exponent is 6. Value of the iota 4 is 6 or 1. Iota 4 is 1, and whole exponent is 6. Then you can write here minus 1 plus 1 upon value of iota 1 is called 1, means iota, and this is called the whole power here 3. After that, First of all, you will check value of the eta 4 here is called plus 1. Value of eta 4 here called is plus 1. This is right one. 1 exponent 6. And 1 exponent 6 is equal to 1. That means 1 exponent 6 is equal to 1. 1 into eta. 1 into eta is equal to eta. 1 into eta is equal to eta. Then this is converted. But this eta came here denominator. Then first remove this. Minus 1 plus 1 upon eta, you will multiply and divide with help of the eta here. Here eta came here denominator, then you multiply and divide both eta eta. What result came here? Minus 1 plus eta upon eta square, the whole exponent is 3. This is minus 1. A value of the eta square here, minus 1. Plus eta upon minus 1 upon whole power is 3. So value of the eta square is minus 1, and this minus 1 plus again minus here. So this will be converted here, minus 1 minus eta is exponent 3. This means your denominator portion has been solved. Your denominator portion has been solved here because eta square came here plus minus 1, a plus minus here minus. Then you can say it means denominator portion has been solved. Then so then you take minus 1 is common, minus 1 exponent taking common here, what 1 plus eta cube. Both first term and second term I am taking minus 1 common. Whole exponent here 3, then write here 3. Minus 1 taking common or what? Exponent here 3, then you write exponent same here 3. This will be right left inside the 1 plus eta whole exponent 3. So what we do, this is for the minus 1 and 1 plus eta whole cube. Eta whole cube. This is convert here. Minus 1 exponent cube means this is the minus. What is left here? 1 plus eta. 1 plus eta is whole cube. So then we will write here identity of a plus b whole cube. What identity of a plus whole cube? This is the a plus b whole cube. This is a cube plus b cube plus 3ab and a plus b. This is the identity of the a plus b whole exponent 3. A cube plus b cube plus 3ab and a plus b. So using this identity in this part. Yes. Minus here, a cube means 1 plus cube 1 plus eta cube plus 3 into 1 into eta and 1 plus eta. Expand this identity here. A plus b whole cube and then here outside here, this minus here right here outside of this. Then this will be checked. 1 cube is 1. Eta cube, what value of the eta cube is minus eta. Value of the eta cube is minus eta. Then write here minus eta. And because eta cube is equal to minus eta, then I am writing here eta cube here minus eta. Then plus 3 eta, 1 plus eta. This minus sign you are seeing, 1 minus eta, multiply inside plus 3 eta. And plus 3 eta square. These 3 eta multiply inside the bracket. 3 eta 1 is 3 eta. 3 eta into eta, 3 eta square. What is left here? Minus 1 eta is minus eta. We calculate here. 3 eta or eta. Plus 2 eta. Plus 2 eta. 3 eta minus 1 eta is plus 2 eta. Are here converting minus 3. Because eta square equal to minus 1. Value of the eta square is minus 1. So this eta square is minus 1. 3 into minus 1 is minus 3. So then what is solved here? Solution here minus 3 is a minus 2 plus 2 eta. Minus 2 plus 2 eta. And this minus sign multiply inside. What value is left? 2 eta minus 2 eta. This is your final answer. This is your final answer. outside minus multiply inside minus minus here plus and minus plus here minus the 2 iota. This is your final answer. This is your final answer. So when you solve in the any question in this type, very carefully, first you break down the identity in even and odd. This is the I will break even and 2 9 then. What will you do? You will break down only 2 exponent 2 3 4 mostly 2 3 4. So then 2 9 get in value of at square is minus 1. Here 24 exponent is bigger exponent here, then you break down 1 and 24. So first you factor of the 24 here, 4 6 are 24, factor of this. A value of the iota 4 here is plus 1, 1 exponent is 6 is equal to 1, but then what is left here only iota. And here iota came here in denominators, then you multiply and divide here, specialize it. Then iota square, this iota square can be minus 1 here, the plus minus again minus, this minus minus sign taking common, 1 plus iota. 1 plus iota whole exponent 3, so using this sign a plus b whole exponent 3, a cube b cube plus 3b, so using this sign here, then you can say 1 iota cube means minus iota, and then multiply here this, calculate and find the value of this. Very simple question, but very carefully when you calculate it, just note down it.